before I continue, I want to instill the man about spiritual life. Some of you don't know how real the spiritual is. Friday night, when I left the prayer here, Andrea was going to be buried on Saturday. When I went to bed around 3:30 a.m. Saturday morning, the moment I closed my eyes, where did I find myself? At the funeral. As I walked in, let me quickly change. People were already seated at the funeral. Andrea was at the door. When I walked in, she asked me, "I thought you were not coming." I asked him, "Why wouldn't I come?" He said, "Come, I want to introduce you to some people." Took me through to the mother, the brother, the people, some friends, and took me to the other side. We sat down together. And started telling me a lot of things. I'm not going to share this one. And then, to cut me short, at the end of it, after telling me all these things, she said, "Look." Immediately she finished telling me, we were sitting like this together, away from the crowd. Immediately she finished telling me, a transparent veil, a divider, came between us. Bah! Divided me and her. She was alone at the other side. I was in this side with a group of people that came from me. But I could hear her, she could hear me, I could see her, she could see me. The countenance changed. She looked at me and said, "My God, they are coming for me." I said, "Who?" He said, "Look at them there." I said, "Where are they taking you?" He said, "Heaven." She looked at me and smiled. He said, "You go to a temporary place first before the final." I said, "Well, it's not going to be that bad." She just looked at me and him like this. I could see a sense of loneliness. I could sense fear in her eyes. Loneliness. She hears. And I woke up. You don't know how the spiritual is so real. If you die today, where will you go? If your end is now, where will you go? If you stop me, throw out up to today. If you stop me, whatever I remember, it's so fresh in my mind. Everything she told me, those ones are private, I will not share that. But I don't want to share the one that is for public consumption. I could still feel it. That big class divided and bam, as it was alone. She said, "You are praying for me." I said, "Why?" He said, "Look at them." He said, "Why are they taking you? Heaven?" He said, "They take you to a temporary place first." The spiritual is very real. God will help us.
Amen.
I want to, I'm using this one to think about your life. You may need to think so much about my life. You know that it's so real. Today is a gift. Nobody promises you tomorrow. You could go home today, you don't wake up tomorrow. You could go home today, you don't reach your house. Where will you go? If it comes, if it knocks to your door, this means. Where did you find yourself? I don't know where Andrea is. I'm bringing this to let us get ready.
Yes.
Amen.
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 Father, thank you. Holy Spirit, minister to your people. Minister to your people. Minister to your people. Speak through me, O God. Let your voice be heard, not mine. Change lives. Change situations. Bring them out of the pits of the enemy by your power. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
And I'm not wasting because the women are about to be fed. Even though the food is too much, I know men will even be fed more than the women. But let's not pretend the women will be fed. Amen.
Amen.
Yes, last week Sunday, I started, well, this one is not the same series, but it's a wisdom principle series. We talked about with you that I said avoiding spiritual initial. We use the law of physics to demonstrate spiritual lessons. We say that what's there based on that law, that an object will continue in motion or rest the same speed, the same direction, unless an unbalanced force causes it to change action.
Yes.
And we say, we use the book of Revelation. Jesus said that you are neither hot nor cold. If you are lukewarm, you will either be hot or cold. If you are lukewarm, you will speak to out of his mouth.
Yes.
And I said that if you are hot, you remain hot. If you are cold, you remain cold. Yes. Unless something happens, then out of balance for which is the power, either the power of God or the enemy, acts on you to cause you to change direction. But you don't have to be lukewarm. We break down the people that are cold, those that are hot, and what lukewarmness means in the things of God. I hope you're able to locate yourself in one of those three categories. And I pray you not locate yourself in the first two. Let it be the cold one, the hot one, that you find yourself. If you are in the cold, I pray that God will move you. You allow God to move you to the hot. If you look for God, we'll move into the heart.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This morning, I'm on another wisdom principle. Say, what goes down will uniquely come up.
Yes.
Say, what goes down,
will uniquely come up.
Oh, I didn't hear that.
What goes down will uniquely come up.
And it didn't say what goes down will come up.
Yeah.
The other law of physics says what goes up will come down because of gravity.
Yeah.
That's the way you fly in the plane, it must come down. If you throw a ball into the air, it cannot go forever. It must be done.
Yes.
Shout hallelujah. Because there's something acting on it and forcing it down.
Yes.
We call that gravity. But this is an opposite to that law. It means that what if you say it? What goes down must. The key word is uniquely. In other words, it's not going to come out the same way. It's not going to come out the same fashion. It's not going to come out the same form. It's coming out from in a different shape. It's coming out in a different dimension. It's coming out uniquely.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
On the spirit of rock bottom, you can never appreciate what it is or what it means to be up and stay up. If you don't experience down, the rock bottom, when you come up, you will not appreciate it. That's how you see people that they have everything made up for them. People that have everything they need in life, available for them, they don't appreciate what they have. Because they never understood what it is to pay the price.
Yes.
That's why if they don't take care, they commit suicide. They go into drugs with so much money, with so much influence, they go into drugs. Why would somebody with so much money go into drugs? Because you never experience the pain, the agony of making it life. So if you experience the rock bottom, you will not appreciate will stay there. Rumble is the darkest point. The darkest point even all. A point where the glory is covered and the light is dimmed. The glory is covered. It covered. The glory has departed. When you feel it, you have lost all. The darkest point in your life. When you appear, the glory has departed. It appears the light is dim. It is covered. Nobody records with you. That is the rock bottom. Some of you might be experiencing rock bottom right now. Some of you might have experienced in the past. Rock bottom is a place of self-doubt and confusion. You are doubting even your own training and skills. There was a time in my life. I was a CPA, MBA. I had no job. When I told people I'm a CPA, they were like, "Are you sure you're a CPA?" Because you know what? Why would a CPA of your MBA and not get a job in America? How can that be possible? Because the boss never doubted my own skills, my own abilities. You know, when you go for interview, because you suffer so much, they ask you simple questions, you don't even know. You are so confused. Because you are there with fear. You want to open your mouth to speak, your lips are shaking. Because it's going to happen again. They will even give you a job. To a place of some kind of confusion, a place where the stone of God rip you into pieces. The stone of God rip you into pieces. A man you used to be, you are no more. A woman you used to be, you are no more. You are ripped into pieces. And you have no clue how to put yourself together again. You don't even know where to turn. You don't know where to go. You don't know what works anymore. That is your rock bottom. Everybody is a very lonely time in your life. Where the true colors of friends become manifest. That is when friends beside you. Because they are waiting you off. This one cannot amount to anything anymore. Don't you know people flow around you when you make it?
Yeah.
So don't you know that?
Yeah.
If you didn't know that, begin to know that. We have so many friends now. God forbid something happened to you. You will see who your friends are.
Yes.
Even family members will write you off.
Yes.
Who were we talking with the other time? There's even family members will not call him again. Who was that? Somebody that we talked to. So even family members won't call him anymore. Because they're like, there's nothing good coming out of this one. So why should we even start wondering to call him? He's gone, he's dead. As far as we are concerned, this one is a nobody. Shout
hallelujah.
It's a lonely time. In your life, everybody that used to be there will forsake you. The right one. There's a rock bottom. A rock bottom is a time when you come to complete end of your understanding. You come to a complete end of your understanding. We are all your life experiences, training, skills come to love. You come to the complete end. And some people say, I don't know anymore. They will tell you God is good in your life. You just smile. You are smile means which God? The one I call for every day, and he doesn't answer me. Some of them tell you, you will make it, you will smile. Me, make it. Forget about that one. I know it's not going to happen. It's been too long. That is the wrong body. I don't know how many of you are in that situation right now. You have hit the rock bottom. And let's see if you know where to escape. Friends, this starts you. Somebody will come and tell you how you carry star and say, which star? That was what they did. What they did to Gideon. Gideon was at his rock bottom. The angel of God came to him and said, you mighty man of valor. Gideon started laughing, said, you must be crazy. Somebody like me can be a mighty man of valor. I'm being chased around by enemies, I'm hiding in the bush. And you dare to come to me and call me mighty man of valor. A mighty man of valor hiding in bushes. You don't understand what you're talking about. Many are like that today. May I ask you, God, why? How long have I not served you? What did I do wrong? Have I not prayed enough? When will be the time when will my prayers be heard? Where are you, Lord? Are you still alive? Did you understand? Where is that God that I heard about? My ancestors told me that divided the Red Sea. Where is that God? Listen to me. I want to bring something else to you. Rock bottom is a school. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Rock bottom is a school. A real school is supposed to equip you with important life lessons. There are two classes of people in any school. Don Apostle concerned Mary with good grades. Doesn't matter how to get a good grade. Some school, you see some student will tell the lecturer, and my grade point average is always 4.0. So please, whatever you do, don't mess that up. You know what? Give me the grade. That's what I want. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I had a counselor like that when I was teaching. The student protested that I was too harsh. How can I be giving somebody C and B? They came to me like, I always make A, and you're messing up my GPA. The dean of the faculty came to me and said, please upgrade them. Shout hallelujah. There are people like that when they pass through the school of life. There are those, the second class. There are those that allow the school to expose them to important lessons, experiences, and skills that will build the foundation of their lives in the future.
In the name of Jesus, yes.
When you are going through the school of rock bottom, if you are the first class, the first set of students, you will live a very frustrated life.
Yeah.
Because what it means is that even if you get out of that rock bottom, you are bound to get into the next one quickly. Because you did not learn important life lessons. God allows rock bottom into your life to refine you, to teach you, to prepare you for your future. Zechariah chapter 13, verse 8 to 11. You are a prophet. A prophecy to a prophet. He said, the whole land, because the Lord, 2 times will be struck down and perish. Yet 1 third will be left in it. This time I will put it to a fire. Say fire.
Fire.
Tell somebody fire.
Fire.
I will refine them like silver. And purge them like gold. They will call on my name. And I will answer them. I will say, they are my people, and they will say, the Lord is our God.
Yeah.
He was talking to the prophets. He said two thirds. These are the two thirds that were concerned about grace. Concerned about grace. And you is to allow you to hit the wrong button. Refinement comes through pain. Refinement comes through sorrow. Refinement comes through affliction. Refinement comes through persecution. It doesn't mean that you have done anything wrong. Sometimes God just allows wrong body to refine and test us, to prepare us. It's not to punish you. Wrong body is not to punish you. It's to prepare you. So that when you get to the door, you'll be able to stay there. The greatest tragedy is getting to the door and you cannot stay. That's the greatest tragedy. When I was in the university, I was all A student. The best student year, 2 year, 3, final year, I made a first class. But before then, in my 3rd year, in one of the 3rd, I started slacking because I like to get into my head that I'm the best. One of the professors called me. He said, Udoh, used to call him that last name. Udoh, come. A lady. Sabi, and I said, I observe you. I've never seen intelligence like this in a very long time. But you know one thing about life, I said, it's not about getting to the top, but staying at the top. They're about to come down. Go back and stay at the top. I let these ladies of his in my car. My perspective, just said, you know what? From that day, I carried my book into the library. Read it. I said, you know what? I must keep this up. I didn't want to get a first class. You know what? I'm aiming now for a first class. I don't really know what happened. I graduated the best all-around students, University of Church. The best student in academic excellence. The only first class that in the entire university.
Amen.
I won all the 9 prizes. I have a proof. I tell my children. They say, oh, all African president. I said, no, I'm not all African president. Come and see. Why? Because I allow the school to teach you important life lessons.
Yeah.
What do you learn from your rock bottom? What do you learn? Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So my God allows you to your rock bottom so that you will discover that it's the rock at the bottom.
Amen.
No, you don't get that. You don't get that.
Amen.
God allows you to hit the rock bottom.
Yes.
So that you understand it's the rock at the bottom.
Yes.
You don't get that.
Yes.
No, you don't get that.
Yes.
Oh. Even at the bottom,
yes,
there's a rock.
Yes.
Yes. The thing asked, is
He said, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, except a corn of wheat falls into the ground and die, it abides alone. But if it die, it bringeth forth much fruit."
Amen. Shout hallelujah. Except a corn of wheat falls into the ground and die. Remember, that. Yes. It will fall into your rock bottom and die to self. Die to emotions. Die to fear. Die to sin. We abide alone. It's only when you fall into the rock bottom and die that you come out of it.
Hallelujah.
Holy Spirit, speak to people.
Hallelujah.
I don't know if you understand the message of this man. Rock bottom therefore becomes a solid foundation on which you live your life. As every child of God that makes impact for God, they need a foundation to build their life. As the disciples of Jesus were, it was the rock bottom that they found the foundation to build their life. You cannot be a solid, well-tested child of God if you don't go through a rock bottom experience and come out victorious. That's why you see half-baked Christians. That's why you see prosperity preaching in your churches filled to the brim. And when they go, they get nothing back in return. One pastor here was telling the member that he need everyone should be 12 members so he can add money and buy a private jet. I don't know how that followed the life of the children of God when they contribute money for you to buy a private jet. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That's the wrong ultimate experience. Joseph got the trainings he needed to be the second in command in prison. Did you get that? The wisdom that took him to the palace came from the prison. From the prison. Look, listen to me. He was in prison and the Lord passion, perseverance, and wisdom. All the tribute that came handy in the palace. Then he went through the school of persecution and trials to learn to be humble and to rely on God.
Amen.
When he got to the truth.
Amen.
Peter denied Christ three times and suffered so much shame and reproach. Thereafter, you know, he went back to family, to fishing.
Yeah.
They denied a small kid. Are you now one of those that were working with this man? Took off for me. Did they grace? How can I work with this man? And when he turned back, he remembered the word of Jesus. He wept. He said, "Look at me, I was about to be the rock. See how I fed this man." He was so ashamed of himself, he went back to fishing. Did you see Peter at the graveside of Jesus?
Mm-hmm.
No. Did you hear that Peter was at the graveside?
Mm-hmm.
In fact, did you even hear Peter was where he was being crucified?
Mm-hmm.
Peter was not there. Not even at the crucifixion plate. Not at the graveside. Not even when Jesus came out of the grave. And it was about to be the rock. Wouldn't you think that the rock would be number one? If it would be the one helping Jesus to the cross. But it was so ashamed. Reproach covered him. He went back to fish. Look what happened to Peter. But I said, Peter.
Oh God.
Shout hallelujah. What are you now? I want to round up this message quickly because of my time. Because it's like Genesis said that it's 11:15. Shout hallelujah. Now, but in the lesson, listen carefully for a while. If the lessons are properly learned, if you are able to discover and better appreciate the rock bottom, or the rock at the bottom, then the bottom cannot hold you. Listen, one second. If you are able to learn properly the lesson, you can read that. You might have gone in beating a battle. Listen to me right now. You might have gone into the building beating a battle. But you are coming out strong and empowered. I don't think someone listening to me this morning. You might have been there beating a battle. And you're coming out strong and empowered. You might have gone in broken and in strife. And you're coming out whole and all rounded. You might have gone in as a captive. I declare to you, and you're coming out as a master. But the second of a shame. You might have gone in darkness, but you're coming out of the place of glory. I don't care the state you're in. I care about how you're coming out. You cannot come out the same way you were in. It is impossible. From a light affliction, all you wanted for us, and I see the eternal weight of glory. I don't care. What is going on in your life? But I come to bring you a message. You are coming out.
Amen.
Oh, you don't get that. I said you are coming out.
Amen.
You are coming out.
Amen.
Not the way you went in. Not the way you are. You are coming out of the storm. You are coming out in power. You are coming out in victory. You are coming out to stand on God. Shout hallelujah. Push me out of sin. Push me out of sin.
the name of Jesus. Thank you, oh God. Thank you, oh God. We give you praise and worship. Thank you, oh God. For your children are being pushed out by your power. Your children are pushed out by the body.
Out of church.
Out of captivity. Out of infirmity. Out of eternity. Have been pushed out. Rock away. Thank you for pushing us out of poverty. Out of the chains of darkness. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We give you praise. We worship you. Thank you, God, for your faithfulness. This week is a week of testimony. I declare and prophesy that this week we will testify. In every area of our lives, we testify in the name of Jesus. And no power can stop us. Thank you for your divine connection. Thank you for your breakthrough. Thank you for your release, O God. In Jesus' name we pray. We start through not fully the blood of Jesus. And with the fire of the Holy Spirit. Father, we pray for the hand that prepared, the hand that provided.